Thank you for joining CACE International. I'm Takesha Kumbo, and we're doing our live showcase jazz at SOB's here in New York City. And our guest is Mr. Leon Lee Dorsey. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you.
Very good. I'm so glad you could join us here at our first live showcase in the club, as a matter of fact.
Pleasure's all mine.
You know, I'm very impressed with your straight-ahead style. Why straight ahead? Most young people aren't playing straight ahead these days.
Well, like most of my peers, I grew up on a lot of R&B and soul and things of that nature, but there was a lot of jazz in our household. And I grew up here in Duke Ellington, Miles, and in Pittsburgh, the jazz tradition is very strong, a long list. Everybody going from George Benson, Stanley Turrentine, back to Earl Father Hines and Art Blakey. So the tradition is very rich there from which to draw from.
I understand. You played with Bohanna,
right.
Art Blakey.
Yeah.
What was that experience like?
That was the most difficult gig I've ever had and by far the most enriching. Something that I take to every performance that I'll probably do in my entire life. I owe some debt to Art Blakey.
Why? Why do you say that?
Well, he brings out the best of you, and every night, everything that you're worth, you have to put it up.
And you have to give it up, huh?
Totally. It's great.
Why'd you choose the bass? And you do play both electrical and acoustic.
I play both. I originally started on cello and just gravitated towards the bass in junior high school and made the transition coming out of high school.
Did I read somewhere that you're working on a doctorate?
I'm on temporary leave of absence from the grad center on 42nd. I'm doing my doctoral studies with Ron Carter.
So what? I'm very thrilled to hear that. What are you going to do with it when you finish?
Well, one of the reasons why I'm not really in the program currently is because, you know, it can help me get a better professorship down the road. And I mean, it's great studying with Ron, but right now I'm most interested in performing and, like what we'll hear a little later, some of the material from my debut album.
Yeah, what's the name of your debut album?
The Watcher.
And how are you going to distribute it? Who's handling it for you?
Landmark Records is the label on which the record is on, and they're distributed through Muse.
Oh, okay. Who are some of your mentors?
Well, you have mentors on and off the instrument. Some of the most names that you hear come up all the time, Charlie Parker, John Coltrane, certainly Duke Ellington, Miles Davis, Thelonious Monk, and more contemporary ones such as Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter, and the list of bass players goes from Jimmy Blanton all the way up to Ron Carter, Ray Brown.
Mm. Did you ever work directly with any of these people in terms of them guiding you along, kind of?
Well, my graduate studies prior to coming to New York was at the University of Wisconsin with Richard Davis.
Oh, yeah.
Who had played with everybody from Sarah Vaughan to Eric Dolphy to Igor Stravinsky. And since being in New York, I've worked closely with Mr. Carter. And that's been a phenomenal experience as well.
I understand you went to Oberlin College.
Yeah, I attended Oberlin for undergrad school.
Mm.
And I have a bachelor in classical performance and jazz performance.
Well, tell us about the story about your playing jazz at Oberlin and what the reaction was.
Well, it's funny because when I got to Oberlin, I guess like most students, you go somewhere and you feel like you have a great deal of knowledge, only to find out you had no knowledge. And I had a really great mentor there as well. Wendell Logan was head of the African American Music Department. And gave us a great deal of opportunity to play and to study one-on-one. And a lot of artists came through there, McCoy Tyner, Woody Shaw, Sam Rivers, the Art Ensemble of Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
So it was like quite fabulous as far as being able to meet that caliber of artists and work with such a great teacher as well.
Yeah. We'll be right back. jazz or classical African-American music has been around and will be around, but it seems to go through changes. What is your impression of who's listening to jazz these days? I mean, when I'm talking about straight ahead now. I'm not talking about, you know, fusion or anything like that.
Well, it's interesting because sometimes you'll see articles from time to time saying jazz is back. But I think, like most things, it's always there. I think people's awareness changes. I don't think the quality or whether something has notoriety changes. I mean, there's always been phenomenal jazz artists in every decade. And whether people take note of it is, that's through media, press, or whatever. That kind of thing can change.
Yeah. So what are you going to play tonight? You know, what are some of the tunes you're going to do?
We're going to do four or five of my originals off the album, The Watcher, including the title track, and two or three standards for just a trio, which I'd also done. And I'd just like to say on the album, featured Don Braden on tenor saxophone, Vincent Herring on alto and soprano, Lafayette Harris Jr. on piano, and Cecil Brooks III on drums, who helped produce the record.
Well, we're looking forward to it tonight, you know? And I want to thank you so much for joining CACE International and doing this great showcase with us.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and thank you for joining us as well.